Hello friends, welcome to the channel Create Your Wealth. I had a question and hence I wanted to answer this. Why create one more channel called Create Your Wealth? There are already hundreds of channels which tells you about how to make money from the stock market. Still we find that 80% of retail or small investors suffer a overall loss in the stock market. Moreover, in the last 3 years, I have interacted with thousands of retail investors and realized that reason behind losing money in the stock market. There are too many misconceptions about investment and more so by the small investors. Many investors prefer to chase the stock tips and earn quick bucks. There are also plenty of free trading tips available across the internet, business channels and print media. Still, many investors end up by losing big in the stock market. The main reason behind losing the money by the individual is because they don't do thorough analysis. When you see that you are investing money in mutual funds, we find that those mutual fund managers are backed by a research team who do fundamental as well as technical analysis about the stock. And they also help them understand how to diversify and how to ensure that they give maximum returns to the investors. Now, if you decide to become the fund manager of your own portfolio, you should definitely do one thing. That is, you need to educate yourself about how you should save your hard-earned money and earn money for yourself. Let me repeat, you have to first save your capital and then think about earning the extra bucks. And you can do this only if you are passionate about stock market and you are passionate about learning how the stock market works. You can see on our channel that we have uploaded many videos on all the fundamental and various other concepts relating to stock market investment. I would request you to go through it and keep educating yourself. And we will continue to upload the next series of videos. Now, in continuation to my previous video where I spoke about the PE ratio, the next one is about PS ratio. What is PS ratio? It is price to sale ratio. Price to sale ratio is another basic valuation tool. It is the current price of the stock divided by the sales per share. You can calculate it by simply dividing the market capitalization of the company by the reported total sales. What is the advantage? The main advantage of this ratio is that the S portion, that is the total sales, is generally not manipulated. Companies that use accounting tricks are more focused on boosting their net profits instead of sales. So, unlike PE ratio, PS ratio is not manipulated too often. Sales are less volatile than earnings. Cyclical companies may report volatile profits but not sales. Moreover, one-time charge can boost the profit but not the sales. That's why this ratio is helpful for the companies with volatile earnings. You can compare the company's PE ratio with PS ratio with its historical average to get the best picture. The main disadvantage of this ratio is that the total sales cannot ensure profit. A company may report billion rupees of sales but at the same time reports negative profits, are in short they report losses. This happens because the sale is not able to translate into profit. In future, even if some of the sales generate profit, it is not enough to generate enough profit for the shareholders. Some firms have very low profit margins and some have very high profit margins. So firms with lower net profit margins have to trade at a very low PS ratio. Most retailers have a low profit margins. For example, Pantaloon has a very high sales number, but at the same time, it has a very low profit margin. Hence, huge sales fail to generate huge profits. The result is lower PS ratio. On the other hand, high margin business like software companies report high PS ratio. So, while judging PS ratio, check the industry and then do your research. Best use. The PS ratio is more useful when you are analyzing stocks with the cyclical industries like auto industry. companies which often report one-time profit or one-time charge can also be valued through this ratio. PS ratio comes handy for any turnaround companies. Simply putting, this ratio is useful for the companies that have unpredictable and unstable earnings. You can get the best result if you compare the stock's PS ratio with its own historical average. If you find a stock is trading much lower than its own historical PS average, then you have to investigate. The stock may be worth investing, but don't take a final decision just by considering a single ratio. The next one is the price to book ratio. The price to book ratio is another important valuation tool. This compares the stock price with its book value per share. Theoretically, the book value per share indicates the amount that each shareholder should receive if the company liquidates completely. It is considered that if a stock has a PB value less than 1, then it is undervalued. What is the best use? It's useful for banking stocks. This ratio is very helpful to analyze banking stocks. Banks have huge liquid assets into their balance sheet. The best part is that most of the assets to mark to market means that the assets are frequently revalued. The book value of the bank is reasonably current and provide a better picture of the current net worth of the bank. The PB ratio works better than the PE ratio while evaluating banking stocks. Capital intensive business. Companies having huge tangible assets can be better evaluated by this ratio. But remain careful. Factory, a piece of land, or any other tangible asset recorded in the balance sheet can, whatever be the form, paid or other different types of current value of that asset. Thus, it can misguide the results. So don't take the final decision based on a single ratio. What are the disadvantages of the PB ratio? This cannot be applied in service sectors. Please do not use PB ratio for software or any other type of service sector because it carries no significance. Service firms are any software companies. Just consider the case of Infosys. They were creating wealth through intangible assets such as brand name, database, industry reputation, etc. Such intangible assets are not recorded on the balance sheet. So, the software companies that generate most of their wealth through their intangible assets cannot be evaluated based on the book value. Inaccurate measurement. As discussed earlier, tangible assets cannot be properly valued based on the current valuation. A factory or a piece of land recorded in the balance sheet at the value the firm paid for it, which is very different from the current value of that land. Moreover, each and every firm carries some intangible assets which are difficult to measure, like infrastructure company like L&T. Despite having several tangible assets, L&T had a strong brand name that makes it a dominant player in its sector. Now, you can't calculate the exact value of that brand name, so it is obviously a higher PB ratio for larger established firm. Now, how do I combine the PB ratio with the ROE? There is a separate video on ROE. Please go through it. I will put the link of that video in the description below. The price to book ratio value is tied with the ROE. Given the two companies that are equal elsewhere, the one with a higher ROE will always have a higher PB ratio. The reason is simple. The company that can return higher value from its equity should easily compound its book value at a faster rate. For example, an average ROE of Bajaj Auto stands at around 50%. That is great. Simultaneously, its stock price also trades at a PB around 8. Hero Honda has a higher ROE and a higher PB. Companies with the ROE and the PB ratio doesn't go hand in hand should be analyzed with extra care. The word of caution. Like every ratio, the PB ratio has several advantages and disadvantages. This ratio is useful for analyzing banking stocks and other capital intensive business, but it does not have any significance for the service sectors like software firms and others. You may get the best results if you are comparing the stock's PB ratio with its own historical average. A lower PB ratio is better investment opportunity. As mentioned earlier, stocks having a PB ratio less than 1 is often considered as an undervalued stock. But before investing, you need to dig deeper to find out the reasons for that valuation. Thank you, stay connected, and happy investing.